The assistive technology that I am demonstrating today is called Simple Mind. Simple Mind is an application that allows the user to generate mind maps in a user-friendly environment. Mind maps are used to visualize one's thought process using shapes, images, and texts that are interconnected. This process can be used as assistive technology when taking notes, brainstorming ideas, organizing assignments, papers, and projects, and gathering any information in an organized fashion for easy recall. Simple Mind is effective at allowing the user to engage in these activities in a straightforward way. Simple Mind is available for Android, iOS, Mac, and Windows devices. It is also cross-platform, meaning you can start a mind map on your Android phone and finish it on your iPad. I created this example of a mind map in preparation for my assistive technology paper. It is a good example of the functionality of a mind map, including color coding, node size and shape, the labeling of nodes and connections, the incorporation of images and hyperlinks, and the automatic formatting of node layout. I first want to talk about the layout of Simple Mind. There are four main sections of the Simple Mind window: the Mind Maps Explorer, the Toolbar, the Style Toolbar, and the Inspector. The Explorer, the Toolbar, the Style Toolbar, and the Inspector. In the Explorer, you can see other mind maps that you've created on your device or in the cloud that you have set up. I can also hide each of these toolbars to make the layout more easy to navigate. In the toolbar, you have your main functionality of the program. In your style bar, you have more detailed functionality of your style, as in the way things are laid out in the nodes and in the text. And finally, you have your inspector that allows you to see your outline, notes that you've taken on specific nodes, as well as icons you can select for the nodes. I just selected a smiley face for my main node. I'm going to clear that icon and again hide this inspector because it makes the layout less busy. One of the things I like a lot about Simple Mind is how easy it is to create nodes and label connections. And all the functionality is very simple to figure out how to use. I'm going to create a new mind map. So this will be my my test mind map to use. And let's call it the demonstration mind map. So it automatically has the parent node generated for you. When I click off the node, several shortcuts appear around the node that will allow me to continue generating this mind map. Basically, the tools found in the toolbar and some of the style tools also are found in this section as well. I think for ease of use and so you can quickly generate a mind map if you're in class taking notes. It would be easy. The plus buttons next to the parent nodes, as they call them, create child nodes. They automatically are created with a specific or randomly selected color. I'm going to say child node 1 and hit enter, and that's generated. If I want to make another child node off of this one, hit enter again, and you can see that the this child node, let's call it A, is the same color as the parent node, which is wonderful that they allow you to do that. If you wanted to change colors or choose your own color, you can use the apply palette color here, or you can add a topic with palette color. When you're adding topics to these nodes, you can add a child topic like we're talking here. Creates the node automatically for you. So this would be child node B. Or if you wanted to do a child node with another color that you wanted specifically, you can choose the button, add topic with palette color. I'm going to choose green this time. It'll create a child node 2 in the color palette that I wanted. So very basic, straightforward how to create and generate these nodes, child nodes, and kind of format the color. Now, say I wanted to actually add a label to the connection itself. I would simply double click the connection and I could do different things. Edit the properties, add text, or remove the connection. I'm just going to add some text so you can see how that works, and the text is generated. Now if I click on any item on the workspace, they all have this little ellipses that I can click and will come up with several functionality options included in this program, including the properties of the text. So I can edit the text here, and it'll show up there. So just another way of doing it. I can also change the style of the text, the formatting layout, the color of the text, which is great. Several different ways to change that color. However you like to operate, as well as the text size, bold and italics. So it just got really big. I can also just click and drag, which makes layout really nice and easy to navigate. Now that we have a basic mind map on our workspace, I'd like to show you more advanced features of SimpleMind, such as adding images and hyperlinks to your nodes. Say, for instance, this child node, I'd like it to be an actual image. I can select an image by going to the menu on that node and clicking the button Add Image. It's going to give me a few options. One option is adding an embedded image, which means the image will be actually inside of the node, or the node will be the image. If I just add an image, it will appear next to the node. So adding just a normal image, let's go with this image of the logo for SimpleMind. Embed in mind map, link to source. I want it to actually be into the mind map so it'll show up. Link to source will just put a link to this particular image. The image shows up and it's kind of free floating, kind of connected to invisibly that node, but not the actual node itself. I'm going to delete that. Now we're going to add the image as an embedded image. Now the node is the image. I can change the size, but you can see the image is actually embedded inside of the node, which is wonderful. Let's say I want to put a link to SimpleMind and their website, and I want to embed that link into this node. So I'm going to put link topic, link to mind map, or link to document. or web page. Link to mind map, it actually allows me to put a link to another mind map that I've generated separately from this mind map. Or I can link to a document on my computer or a web page. And I want the web page, simplemind.com. You can test the link before you do this, and it works. Simple Mind's website is not .com, it is .eu. I'm going to change that, and then test the link again. And it takes me to Simple Mind's website. Fantastic. Go back to Simple Mind. I'm going to hit OK. And now there's a link right in that node that I can access later on for future reference. I can see that being very helpful if you've visited a website in class while taking notes, if you've visited a website that you are referencing for a paper and you're using a mind map to do a layout of your paper, or just to collect your thoughts and do brainstorming. That way that information is easily accessible with a click of the button whenever you have this mind map open. All students can benefit from the process of mind mapping. However, there is a population of students who can uniquely benefit from the visual aspects of this assistive technology. Students with learning disabilities, such as dyslexia, can greatly benefit from having a visual aid to represent new information. Other learning disabilities require processes to be broken down into smaller parts. This process gives a student a tool they can use to help with reading comprehension, writing, and information recall. Students who struggle with recall or the anxiety that surrounds memory and the recall of newly learned information can use Simple Mind to help organize that new information in a visual way that promotes retention. The process also allows students to organize learned information with new information, which also promotes retention.